Welcome to two examples of determining the probability of the complement of an event. The probability that an event A will not occur is called the complement of event A. And we can say the probability that A will not occur is equal to 1 minus the probability that A will occur. Let's look at an example. One card is selected from a deck of playing cards. What is the probability the card is not a diamond? The probability the card is not a diamond must be equal to 1 minus the probability that the card is a diamond. Here's a picture of a deck of playing cards. There are a total of 52 cards, and there are a total of 13 diamonds, which means the probability the card is not a diamond must be equal to 1, or 1 over 1, minus the probability that the card is a diamond, which would be 13 out of 52. Again, there are a total of 13 cards that are diamonds. Let's go ahead and find this difference. The common denominator would be 52, so multiply both the numerator and denominator by 52. So the denominator stays 52. The numerator would be 52 minus 13, which is equal to 39. So the probability that the card is not a diamond would be 39 divided by 52. Notice how there would be 39 cards that are not diamonds. Now this does simplify. There's a common factor of 13. This simplifies nicely to 3/4. Hopefully this makes sense. We can see there are 4 rows of 13, 3/4 of the cards are not diamonds. And since probability can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage, let's go ahead and write this as a decimal. 3 divided by 4 is equal to 0.75. Convert this to a percentage, we multiply by 100, add a percent symbol, or move the decimal point to the right two places, this would be 75%. Let's go and take a look at a second example. 20 ping pong balls are numbered from 1 to 20. What is the probability of selecting one ball and it is not greater than 17? Well, the probability that the ball is not greater than 17 must be equal to 1 minus the probability that the ball is greater than 17. So looking at the balls, let's determine how many of them are greater than 17. Well, 17 is not greater than 17, but 18, 19, and 20 are. So there would be 3 balls out of 20 that are greater than 17, which means the probability the ball is not greater than 17 must be equal to 1, or 1 over 1, minus the probability of the ball being greater than 17. There are 3 balls greater than 17 out of 20. So 3/20 would be the probability the ball is greater than 17. Let's go ahead and subtract. Common denominator is 20. So we have 20 minus 3, which is 17. 17 divided by 20 is also equal to 0.85, which is also equal to 85%. Again, 17 divided by 20 is equal to 0.85. If we want, we can verify this. And there it is. And remember, the original probability was the probability that the ball is not greater than 17. It should be the same as saying it's less than or equal to 17. So if we go back and take a look at the listing from 1 to 20, notice there are 17 numbers that are not greater than 17. The numbers 1 all the way through 17, giving us a probability of 17/20. I hope you found these two examples helpful. Thank you for watching.